Hi there, Tracy here with another scrapbooking process video. This one is starting off a little bit differently than usual because there's been a lot of conversation on the Facebook groups that I'm involved in, as well as on my YouTube channel, just about layering and how I go about layering. Of course, there's no right or wrong way of layering, and I'm no expert or anything, but I just kind of do what I like doing, and then a lot of times people will comment on what I've done, why did you do that, or how do you decide how much to layer, or when to stop, or what layers to put together in what ways. And so I thought I would share a little bit more in-depth information about how I decide on my layers. So anyhow, I have the This is Halloween add-on only, so I don't have the main kit. This was one of the October kits from the Scraptastic Kit Club. So the add-ons have less pattern paper and more embellishments, and usually two sets of letter stickers. So I have this add-on, and I'm going to scrapbook these two, well, at least this one picture. I'm going to call this Sugar Rush, and it's a picture that was on my Instagram. It's not like the best picture. It's not even all of us. It's only, it's those of us who went trick-or-treating together. Scott was working that night, and Sophia, my other teenager, she was next door doing her own thing. And so I had one of the teenagers and two of the children with me, and we went trick-or-treating and came home, and we sorted out all of our candy and checked it for safety and ate a little bit of candy. And this was kind of like a fun memory of us. I took out my selfie stick and we took a couple of shots of us. My house is a mess in behind. You can see like clutter everywhere. And we're all kind of like at the end of the night, so our costumes are all rumpled and stuff, but that's okay. It was a fun moment and I really wanted to capture it, so that's that. And then this was from earlier the same day. We were making Halloween melts, and the kids were being very artistic about it and painting the insides of the molds before they filled it with the melted candy. And so I want to capture this memory too. It's a more kind of subdued moment on Halloween day, so I wanted to kind of maybe compare and contrast maybe two side-by-side layouts. I don't know, we'll see how it goes. I do have a few other Halloween shots that I could scrapbook. They're not awesome, but you know, these two in particular, these two right here, capture the two girls carving pumpkins, and that was their first time carving pumpkins because they don't really celebrate Halloween in the same way that we do where they're from. So I think that these are two that I would really like to get documented in particular. The rest of them, and this is one of the, I don't have a nice close-up of this pump. We took some, but they didn't turn out quite as nice, so I don't know. We'll see. I might go back and we'll see what I do. Anyhow, I'm going to focus on these two for now. This one especially. I don't know if I'll do one or two layouts in this session of scrapbooking. I guess it depends on how elaborate I go with it. But my main objective with Halloween layouts is to have fun and to use product, believe it or not. So I mean, obviously I want to capture the memories too, but this is my time. It's kind of like a bit of a free-for-all. Like, I kind of don't care how it looks. I'm more interested in using these awesome stickers and getting it all on there in a way that's fun for me for today, fun for me to look back on other days, and that captures the story and the photo. So that's sort of my goal for today, so we'll see how it goes. I'm just going to move this out of my way and talk a little bit about my process here for picking layers. So I'm going to kind of put you on pause and fast forward intermittently through this, so I might come back and talk as I'm doing it as opposed to in the narration. I haven't quite decided yet, but here we go. This will be the first fast forward part. Okay, here we go, fast. I am deciding pretty early on that I'm going to use that black, pearly, glittery type of background paper. And I really liked the pattern on this 4x6 card on the cut apart. So I decided to use that as one of my layers right off the bat. So those were my first two easy ideas. And then I really, really love this,
spiderweb paper, and as I flipped it around to cut it, I realized I also really like the back side of it. So I decided right off the bat, again, making decisions pretty quickly here, quicker than usual actually, to mat it with that. I love having a dark mat around my photo, and I'll talk a little bit more about that in a few minutes. So you see that I'm starting off right off the bat with those two pattern papers, one going horizontally, one going vertically. And I'm just going to use my ruler to tear. That gives me a little bit more texture. And I love that pumpkin paper. And this paper I love, but I'm only going to take a little bit of it. What I love about it is how bold it is. So I can get a sense of the boldness just by taking strips, because the contrast between the black and white is very obvious and strong. So this is another paper that I really like both sides of. So I want a thin strip of the stripes. So I just marked it with my scissors so I would know exactly how thin I wanted it to be. And I love these stripes. There's such a bold, unexpected element. All the other things are very Halloween themey, and that one is a lot more neutral. So I like that about it. And I also really like this paper here. So I'm figuring out how I'm going to stick it in a way that looks like it's all one piece of paper. And it was a little bit too wide. It was covering up too much of the other stuff, so I decided to make it a little bit more narrow.
Okay, so I'm back, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the choices I made here with my layering. So, first of all, this orange piece with the words on it, I would have liked it to have been a little bit wider, but I was limited because it wasn't a piece of pattern paper. It was cut apart, and it is 4x6. I can't make it any bigger than 4. So, I either have to kind of layer it so that the picture hangs off of it a little bit at the bottom, or so there's just a slither of orange at the top and the bottom. And I lean towards having the slither at the top and the bottom just because that's the way I am. That's the kind of thing I prefer. So you'll notice that this cluster of papers, this what's building into some layers, has a lot of things going vertical and a few things going horizontal, and the picture itself is a square. So I have these two pieces here that look like one that run this way, and this one runs this way, and then this one is sort of square. This one with the spider webs is more of a vertical, and this one is a vertical. So I always like to have some balance between the horizontal and vertical elements. So far everything on this has corners. There's nothing rounded yet, and so that'll be something that I will want to build in to the design at some point. Although it does look good just all squarish, and maybe that could be something that I might decide to go with, is just kind of make this one be very angular. That would be a look as well. One thing that I'm mindful of as I'm designing this layout on this piece of paper that I understand is a little reflective, and you guys aren't gonna see this as well. It's gonna be a little bit overexposed or underexposed or whatever happens on my camera, but this paper is a glossy piece of cardstock that has like a satiny shimmery kind of a finish on it. So if I'm adding mist to this, it's not going to stick as well as it's not going to sink in the way it does with a regular pattern paper. And even with cardstock, it doesn't usually sink in quite as well, but this cardstock, it definitely won't sink in. So I'm trying to keep in mind that I probably won't be doing much ink splatter on this one. So that's another thing that I'm sort of thinking about at this phase. I decided to put this and this on because I liked the boldness of the white words on the black paper, and I didn't really want to add more patterns to this cluster right here. So what I decided to do was run a strip on the top and on the bottom. I will often do this just as a way of adding some interest to the top and the bottom, and kind of framing out the page and making it look a little bit more complete. It also kind of makes the overall layout look a little bit more horizontally oriented instead of a square. Like the workspace that I have left once you mask off this and this is slightly less than 12, whereas this is 12, so it gives it a little bit more of a squat appearance, and emphasizes the fact I've got lots of vertical here, so I want to kind of emphasize the horizontal. So these two lines there helps to emphasize that. My choices of patterns are this. I like to, when I'm, especially when I'm using a black background or any kind of a dark background, I like to have something right by the photo that's similar to that, because it sort of anchors the photo and makes this make better sense. If I didn't have this here, this would look very harsh, and so this just brings some darkness into my layers. And having it right by the photo means that it's staying on top, it's not going to be covered by anything, so that square mat all the way around that is uninterrupted, unless if I put a little embellishment or something over it, it's not going to be very interrupted, like a lot of these other papers are quite interrupted. So that's one thought. And then I also wanted to bring some other black into the layers, so I chose this paper because it has the black polka dots, and this because I find that kind of a broad diagonal stripe is a bold feature, and everything was looking a little bit too fine lined. Like there's this spider web print here. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can see what I'm talking about a little bit better. So this spider web print has fine lines. This has fine lines. This, even though it is a little on the boldish side, it's still fine lines, so I wanted something bold. I would have liked this better maybe like this. I thought about putting it like this to bring it into the layers a little bit more, but then I'm really just ending up with these two little, these are kind of like cut off from the rest of the layout. They look strange to my eye. It separates that pattern too much, and I want to be able to take in all of that pattern. So I slipped it behind instead, and I like that a little bit better. So these are my layers. And as I layer them together, I'm mindful of a couple of things. I don't want them all symmetrical, like all nesting inside of each other. I've mentioned that before. I want my edges to kind of bounce around. Like if I look at the top right-hand corner of all of my papers, I don't want them to go do, 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 and I also don't want them to go do, 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 do. I want them to go kind of like an in and out. So here we go, out, 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 in, out. So that's better than if it was all out, 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 right? So yeah. And then if you count this corner too, it's like out, 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 in, in. So I like that, and then another out. So I like that, and then of course the same thing will happen on the other side if your papers are rectangular shaped, and it'll happen on all the corners. If you just take care of one corner, it'll naturally line up on the other corners. Now this one here does go out, 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 because these are different widths of papers. So I'm just kind of keeping that in mind in terms of, you know, that might be something I want to either cover or maybe not draw attention to, or I don't know exactly how I'm going to deal with that. I think I want this to go down like this, because actually I think I want it to go like this. See, I'm sort of still playing around with, is this going to be over here, is it going to be centered, and all of those sorts of details. And I'm just mindful of the corners, really. The corners are what I pay the most attention to. Not everybody might do it that way, but that's the way that I do it. What I definitely don't want is this, so I don't want to place it here where this and this line up so well. Don't want that, because it's just less interesting, and if I pull it back here, it just is a little bit better in my eye. It just looks better to me. If I do put it over, I'll put it over here, which leaves me some space here to do some embellishing or maybe put a title or something like that. I'm kind of liking this. This is a little bit too centered. It's too predictable, too, I don't know. So, yeah. So anyhow, that's how I think of my layers. I'll be back.
Okay, so now I am going to just put some of these papers aside now that I've already chosen my layers. And now I'm just going to snap a quick photo so that I can remember how to put everything back together once I've done my outlining. And I particularly like outlining when I use a black background because it does tend to, as I mentioned before, I like to bring some black into my layers, and using a black pen for outlining is just one more way to do that. It also provides some nice definition between your papers. It helps similar papers from getting lost amongst one another. It helps them to stand out as individual pieces instead of all blending in. And it also emphasizes those corners that I've been talking about in the other part of this video. So I'm just taking them apart slowly and outlining all around each one. And it gives them a finished look as well. And I'm just putting them back roughly in the same order that they were in, thinking I might not need to refer to my photo, but it turns out I do refer quite a bit to my photo, and I put them back in it pretty much exactly the same place they were before. I don't always do that. Sometimes I take the photo and then I never do look at it again. Other times I really stick to the photo quite closely. So you'll notice that I did not outline that bold striped paper. I'm talking on the phone while I do this, so my apologies for my hands going everywhere. I didn't outline the last paper, the striped one, because I was thinking that I didn't want it to look too matchy-matchy. I think I'm going to talk about that in the next time that I talk, so I won't say too much about it right now. As I put them together, I'm referring to my photo. Because I had worked it out so much, I don't usually work it out quite as much, but it's because I'm doing this video for you guys that I had really thought of it a lot more, so I kind of knew where I needed things to go, and just referring to the photo made it a lot easier. No point in looking at all those corners twice when I've already looked at them and figured it out when I was talking to you guys earlier. So now I'm just using my hands to flip up the edges and corners on most of the pages, especially with a Halloween layout. I like it to have lots of texture, and so flipping up those corners does that for me. I'm going to use my tiny attacher to staple these strips in place, and I'm not too worried about how straight or lined up they are. I hand cut them. They're not completely straight, and that's okay. I kind of like them off kilter like that a little bit. And I believe I'm coming back right now.
Okay, so as you see, I have outlined some of the pages of the papers. Not all of them. I didn't outline this one. It seemed bold enough as it was. And I didn't want to get too matchy-matchy with it. And I didn't want to outline these because it's too fussy and I didn't think it would add much. So I think if I'm not going to outline one, I'd rather not outline two so it doesn't look like I forgot. So there we go. We've got that. And I haven't quite decided where I'm leaning towards over here. It just makes good sense from a design perspective for it to kind of look like this, like a C-shaped layout. I'm not opposed to doing it in the center. I probably would not put it over there, but maybe I would. I don't know. Maybe I should be open to that. Anyhow, I haven't decided where exactly it will go. It will partially depend on how this evolves. I never have any idea of exactly what I'm doing when I do it. It just kind of comes together, and then I either like it or I like it less. Okay, so now the pattern papers are layered, and now I need to think about which embellishments I'm going to put in amongst these layers. So one thing that comes to mind is a black doily, so let me just go and see if I have one. I'm not entirely sure that I do, because if I don't, then I don't need to think about how I'm going to incorporate that, so just a second. Here are my doilies. I see something black amongst them, so yes, I do have a black doily. Black doilies are the kind of thing that I don't use all that often unless if it's Halloween, so it's a good thing to check for at this point. Yeah, I have one. Well, I have two, but I'm not going to use them both. So I'm going to keep that out and think about using it. The reason that doilies are great in these kinds of clusters of layers is, as I've already mentioned, there's a lot of angles and straight lines, and so a doily is a great way of softening that, whether you kind of stick it in something like sticking out from here, it's too big for there, obviously, but you know, you could stick it in kind of there, like just have a little edge of it showing here, and here might be nice, just to kind of soften it up. So with that thought in mind, because these are already glued down, I only have so much space. I'm definitely going to be cutting this up if I'm going to use it. So let's cut a little strip off of it there, and cut a little strip off of it there, and see what we have to go with. So sometimes you just have to try it to see if it'll look good. Don't be afraid to cut things up, because even if I don't use it here, I'll just put back those two pieces and use it next Halloween or next time I do something that might need a black doily. So I'm actually kind of liking that. The only thing that I don't like about it is that it's not centered with the picture if I put it there. I could kind of move it over there. It kind of draws more attention to the picture if I put it like that. Yeah, I'm thinking about that. I'm not in love with that yet, but I might grow to love it more as time goes by. I think I just need less of it showing. There's too much. Yeah, I like that. Maybe even a little bit less. I'm running into the little edge of glue, so it won't go down any more than that. Like that? Yeah, I like that. I'm wondering if I needed as big of a piece. There we go. Yeah, I think I'm liking that. I'll leave it there for now. I'm not going to glue it down quite yet. I am going to hang on to this because these little ends make nice things to peek out from the edges of things like this. In another context, not this, but, you know, they look good like that. So I'm going to hang on to it. So I'm not going to glue that down yet, but that makes another potentially nice layer in there. So far, that's the only thing for my stash. Everything else here came from the kit. So as I think about what embellishments, and I'm looking at this sticker sheet in particular because it represents the flat embellishments, I want to think about more curves. So these circular ones are standing out at me. And these little banners, although they're not curvy, they are standing out at me too. This one is quite nice and has some kind of curvy lines on it. My worry is that it's going to get lost because it doesn't have an outline. So if I use this, I will be outlining it, and probably with a bold outline. So I'll probably use, I think it might look nice right there. The nice thing about that is that it would fill in this little corner here. Let me zoom in a little bit more. If I were to put this right here, I think it would add a nice, and if it were outlined so that it were more bold, it would do a nice job of covering this little inner corner and just adding a little bit of interest right there. So I'm going to keep that in mind for right there. It is a sticker, so I can't put it down until I'm ready to know that that's where I want it to be. So the kind of outlining I would do for that would be a bold outline. So I would be using the 1.2 millimeter end of my Zig pen. So let me just do that right now and see how I like it. It is hard to outline on a scalloped edge. So, oh, this might be too bold. I'm kind of regretting this. It's been a while since I've used this pen and I forgot how bold it is. But let's just go with it. I've already done it, so there's nothing that I can do to change it. Might as well finish it and see if I like it. It's a little bit hard to see the edge here.
So through the magic of video, I will speed this up so that you guys don't have to watch me struggle with outlining a sticker. You guys know how to do that. Here we go.
So let's look at that. So I do really like that, actually. And I like how it's going to cover up a little bit of the clutter in the back of my picture if I put it there. If I do put it there, I'm going to pop dot it so that it has a bit more dimension. So let's put some pop dots on it right now. These are Stampin' Up! Dimensionals. I like the thickness of them. so then I can kind of play around with it a little bit too. All right, so I'm going to leave that there. And obviously I'll want to put something below it, so let's look. Let's look at what else we have. Zoom out so you can see the overall. And I think if I put that there, and it's black, I might want something with some black, but not, I don't know, what do I want to do there? Ghosts and goblins and ghouls, oh my. I could put something that will hold my title, something like maybe this, or some journaling. It's black though, I wish it wasn't black, because that's black. This is how slow I scrap. let's see. If I put the witch sticker right here, it covers all of the mess on my couch or on that chair. It also softens up this edge a little bit. And then I could put this here. I would definitely want something more colorful underneath of this, though. I wouldn't want this to be alone there. I'd want something under it with more color, because it's kind of being lost in the darkness of the chair. Or maybe it isn't, I don't know. This is why I do things on fast forward, because I take a long time. Let me think about what else I have. Yes, I forgot about these guys. So I could, if we put her back where she was, I can put a big eek right below her. I'd rather put something gold, spooky. No, it's too big.
So you can see that my process is quite slow in real life when when I'm going at regular speed. So I've decided to put a little bit of a word salad journaling here. And what I mean by word salad is just words that stand out as being relevant to the night and the experience and what I want to remember about it, but that don't necessarily make good grammatical sense. So first I noticed that the ring on that circle sticker would make a good, remember how I was looking for something colorful to go behind that witch? So before I forgot that idea, I decided to follow up on it and make sure that I got that ring on the witch. It has a phrase behind it, but you sort of lose the meaning of it when it's covered partially by the witch, but that's okay. Now I'm using the Stampin' Up! Dimensional Adhesive to just fill the space so that that combination of embellishments is going to stand in the right way that I want it to. It's going to kind of take up the right amount of space so that it's layered properly with the things behind it. And now I think I'm going to start talking again.
I'm already liking how this, first I'll let you know that I just put this little two layers of stickers on here, and I just added some dimensional adhesive to have them kind of stand up and not fall too far back behind these layers of paper that I already have. Then I have this sticker from the Authentic sticker set, and it's going to be my journaling piece, and I'm really liking how it's going to line up. I'm going to have to zoom in so that you can see this, but I like how the tab is going to line up with the corners of my layers. So I've got a corner here and a corner here, and see how the tab is it has like a cutoff corner, but it reads as a softer corner than the rest. And I like how when I layer it over this line, I want to completely cover this white line, it's still going to stick out enough that it's going to sort of replace this harsh edge with a softer rounded edge. So I really like that quite a lot. Those are the kinds of details that I look at. Now, as far as how high I want it to go, if I put it right here, it's going to line up with this too much. So I'm going to shift it up a little bit more. It'll still cover that corner, but now this will see, I'm going to have to kind of bring it in a little bit more because I don't want it to line up too much with this edge or with that edge. So I'm going to pull it in a little bit like that. And that way this corner will still hide that, or not, it's not so much that I want to hide it. It looks okay the way it is, but it softens it up. It adds, remember how I talked about how I've got a lot of harsh corners? This is what I mean by wanting to soften it up with some of the embellishments that I use. So this softens up this bunch of corners that were right underneath of it. And now this will, to a smaller extent, soften up the harshness of this corner right here. So that's what I want to do in a way that still the top of it still looks pleasing to my eye. So that's what my thinking is. I'll put you back on fast forward.
Okay, so I have these authentic letter stickers. They're not letter stickers, they're word stickers. And I am thinking about picking some relevant words to the night. I'll let you know the ones that I'm picking. Well, you'll be able to see the ones I'm picking. So dressed up in our costume. And they didn't have the word costumes, and I didn't want to worry about it too much. Again, I'm taking a word salad approach to this, so I just want words that stand out as being relevant. They don't have to make good sense. So dressed up in our costume, trick or treat was another one. And you'll see that I'm sort of doing it in a funny order, and that's because I want it to look random, and I want it to fill up the space, but also have spaces that aren't filled as well. Fright, candy, and fun were the last two that I chose. And now I have that block of, you can't see it because I'm a little bit off screen, sorry about that, but I think I'll move it in a second and you'll get to see that there's a space there that I'm trying to cover. I took one of those enamel shapes. I tried two different pumpkins. Sorry that it all happened off screen. Oh, darn it. I just forgot that I was zoomed in. I thought you could see all of this. But I tried one pumpkin. It looked too big. I tried another pumpkin. It was too small. I went back to the big one. It was still too big. Funny how that remains the same. And then I picked a word sticker from the sticker sheet. It says creepy. And it's on a little bit of a banner, so it's a little different. It's a different color and a different shape and a different font, so I thought it looked pretty cool there. Now I'm just using those Stampin' Up! Dimensional adhesive again. I use a little bit more of them when I'm using a sticker because I don't want the sticker to get flattened and stick to the layer below it. I used my roller date stamp and some pumpkin spice ink from Stampin' Up! For the date, October 31st, of course. And I just want something orange on that witch sticker. It's just too, I didn't want all the orange to be behind it. I wanted to bring some orange forward. So I just put a little dot on her hat. I'm not entirely in love with that, but it's what I went with and I'm sticking with it. Then I put two more enamel dots down on the journaling card. And here I am thinking about where I'm going to stick this big cluster now that it's all finished or ish, almost finished. So of course, where I place it will depend on the size and shape of my title. So I'm just going to spell that out. I knew right from the beginning. I don't usually know the title at the beginning, but I knew right from the beginning that this would be called Sugar Rush. It comes from my Instagram account. That's, I think, one of the hashtags I used. And so I thought it made a good title. I love the chunky glitter letter stickers in this kit. I absolutely love them. They're awesome. So I'm playing around with where to put it, and it fits so nicely in that little corner. I can't resist putting it there. So that's where I'm going to put it. And I understand that that causes some problems for me, like for the way that I do layouts. It makes it hang there in space. But I'm going to do it anyways because I thought sometimes it's just nice to do something different. It doesn't, you know, I almost never dangle my titles out in space like this. So I thought, well, I'll do it this time and see if I like it. Just that corner was just so enticing. I couldn't resist putting a title in it. So I went with it. Of course, I was sitting down when I did it, so my title floated up as I went. So I had to stand up here and have a look and move the letters down. So you can see right away that there's a bit of a problem, at least to my eye, there's a bit of a problem with this title in that it is really not very readable. Even though it's orange on a black background and you'd think that that would be readable, I think there's something about the way that the glitter makes the title reflective in some places and not in others that makes it just really difficult to read. So this was something that I almost had a pit in my stomach as I started to do this because it could have gone very, very badly. So I haven't done this for a while, but I do find it a really good way to increase the readability of your title and to make a title stand out more and have more emphasis as well. And that is to outline around the outside edges of the stickers where they meet the paper, just outline it with a marker. I almost always use a black marker, but of course that wouldn't emphasize this title very much because it would blend right in with the background paper. So I'm using my white gel pen. And the reason I was a little nervous, but I almost never get nervous about stuff, but this was one of those things that I'd worked really hard on this layout so far, and I really didn't want to mess it up. And once you start doing this, it's sort of, you're committed to doing it all the way. You can't undo it. So I told myself, well, if I hate it, I can always pull up the stickers, slap something else down, and cover it up with something else. I really did not want to do that. So I was hoping and hoping and hoping that it would work. And I do like the way that it turned out. It looks good, especially where there is white elsewhere in the layout. I think it looks particularly good. When you're doing this, one tip that I will give you is to hang on to the letter sticker, because if you're kind of like leaning your marker against the letter sticker in order to get it in exactly the right place and the sticker moves, that can result in some stray lines that look really bad and that are difficult to hide or cover up. So see how I'm using one finger there to hold on to that letter? That's because that letter was shifting around a little bit as I outlined it. And you'll see that I did that a couple of times here. I'd go again with the U. It just wasn't staying still. So I'm just holding it down so it doesn't move. And because the cardstock is bumpy, you'll notice I'm going back and forth and back and forth a lot. That's because the cardstock is textured and I wanted to have it look as smooth as possible. Oh, I really like that. That deserves a freeze frame. There you go. So I like that. It does increase the readability a little bit. And so here I go. I thought about having it dangle out there and hang in space, and I just didn't like that look. You guys know that that's not something that I typically do. It looked okay, there was nothing wrong with it, but I thought, oh, I gotta connect it to the rest of it a little bit better. So I put that little strip of that sticker that has words on it, it's an orange sticker, and that kind of connects it into the layers, but it's going to cause a problem that I'll tell you in a minute. Then I knew that I wasn't going to be able to do any splatter on this, so I put these bats and stars up in the sky instead of a splatter. That cat is not working there, is it? And I'm thinking and thinking about what am I going to do. I pull it off and I'm going to put something else there instead. I think that this works a little bit better. That cat was just so shiny. It was demanding your attention. I really do love the cat, but it was just bringing your attention to the wrong place. I don't want you to say, oh, there's a layout with a cat on it. I want you to look at the layout itself. So just had to kind of stick my layers down a little bit better, and now I'm putting in my little pop dots for extra lift so that when this is in my album, it doesn't sit down. The corners are going to stand up. And yeah, so when I was putting the stars and the bats, I made sure that they go in what would be the sky of this layout. I didn't want any of them down below, just to kind of stick with the meaning of the embellishment. And now I'm just putting some outlining on that so it doesn't look so much like a last minute choice, even though it was a last minute choice. Don't want you to know that. And I'm going to come back and talk a little bit about the problem that this causes.
All right, so here we are back to real time. And I put this here, this strip, which is a sticker from the Authentique sticker set. I put it right here just to kind of attach my title to my layers a little bit to make it look a little bit less like it was dangling out there. I might have mentioned that in the narration, I'm not sure because I'm doing the narration after this, but that leaves me with these two layers here kind of ending at too much of the same place. You see that this one extends a little bit beyond that, but not quite. I would like it to go down a little bit further now that this layer kind of juts out from behind it. So what I'm going to do to fix that is I'm going to actually, I can't pull up all this paper and then take this off and pull it down. That would be involve too much deconstruction. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up these layers and cut this paper where it's hidden. So like right here, it doesn't have to be cut perfect because the cut is going to be hidden. And now I just want to extend it down a little bit so that it looks like it's still the same piece of paper, but that it just naturally extended down further than what I had originally had it. So that's the way I'm going to do it. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that. And now I'm thinking that I might like a piece of this sticker to stick out on the other side as well. So I'm going to peel this back. I think it's going to peel off pretty easily because it's on that paper that is like a glossy finish. So it did peel off okay. Just going to stick that there. I'm going to put a bit more glue on this and stick it up into there so that it's ending at a place where I want it to end. And I'm kind of judging how far it is from this. I want it to be about the same and about the same over here too. So that looks good. I don't want or need it to extend too far, but just further than it was extending before. So now we've got a definite noticeable little angle here. And I'm going to have to outline this piece because it used to be hidden, so I didn't bother outlining it, but now it's not hidden, so I'm going to have to outline it. And I didn't outline the edges because it has this kind of faked ripped look. So I just need to extend my marker lines a little bit and have this kind of stick out from back here. Oh yeah, I like that. That looks good. Might be a little bit too high there. Let's see, let's bring it down a little bit. I just want it to kind of naturally look like it's the same piece. There we go. So it's a little cheater method for if things end up lining up a little bit differently than you thought. So here's this layout. I hope that you guys have enjoyed me taking a little bit slower. This is not going to be what I typically do with my process videos, but since I'd had so many requests for a little bit more details about the layering process, I thought I would take my time on this one and show you guys what I do. So I hope you enjoyed it. And here are the close-ups. And after I'm done showing you these close-ups, I will put some of the photos of this layout. There's a little white piece there. Get rid of that. There we go.
So again, thanks so much for watching, and I hope you all have a really great scrappy week.